It's hard because I keep rolling
away. Come back!
Ah! Okay. I recently got eyelash extensions back. I guess maybe a month and a half ago. And I got them because I was wearing the band. Tyler's here, so I want to keep looking at her. I was wearing the whole band extensions, eyelashes. I was wearing the Ardell Demi Wispies, which I absolutely love. And I love the look of them because they're fluffy and they have volume, but they're still kind of natural looking. So I went to a place that's local to me and I liked the experience. It was the place was really beautiful and they had this really comfortable bed to lay on. They give you a blanket. And the woman who was doing my extensions was super nice and we had a nice conversation. The one thing I did notice is that they felt a little, I guess now looking back, they felt heavy, but at the time I didn't know that that's what the issue was. I thought that they were just my eyelids, I guess a little bit, right here was sore. And I thought it was just because of the application. It was something I wasn't used to. So that being said, I was getting the classic, and I'll explain the difference between classic and volume. So classic is an individual lash attached to your individual lash. And volume are a few lashes attached to your individual lash. So it gives you more of a voluminous look, and it also gives you more of an eyeliner look. So I was getting the classic and then I would put on eyeliner, and part of the problem is that I feel like it was kind of messing with the integrity of the adhesive on the lashes. And so when I would have to remove the liner, it was making me feel like I had to, it was making me feel like I was removing lashes as I was trying to remove my makeup. Even though I was doing it super duper carefully and I wasn't using any oil-based anything, it still was kind of taking that, making me feel like I'm pulling lashes out. I wasn't really, but they did feel sore for, I would say, about 3 or 4 days, sometimes a little longer, and my eyes would get super duper itchy. And now I was going to this place and they were using, for sensitive eyes, adhesive for sensitive eyes specifically, and it didn't have nearly as many toxic ingredients in that adhesive. And I thought that was the best choice. But one, I think the one thing that happened is that it really wasn't keeping the lashes on for as long. So then I had gone back a couple more times and then I asked for volume lashes, which I definitely liked better, but I still never really got the look I was going for, even though I did show pictures. And I don't fault the woman who was doing my lashes. I think it might have been, I don't really know why we weren't making that connection. I don't know, I think sometimes it's just really good with anyone who is, whether it's nails or hair or lashes or facials, anything, it's just really good to be able to have a relationship with the person who is servicing you. And for some reason, it just wasn't connecting. Like I said, she was lovely. I had a good experience and they looked good, but it just wasn't hitting that home run that I was like, yes, this is perfect. So I considered taking them off or just letting my lashes grow out, because you can have them removed, but you can also just let them grow out. And when you lose your regular lash, that false lash that's attached will come out as well. So it's just a normal shedding that goes on with our bodies, right? So a friend of mine knew somebody who's local to her, and she referred me to her and she said, oh, this woman is doing lashes. I know you were talking about getting your lashes done. She's really, really good. She seems to have she's seen her pictures online and she seems really great. So I found this woman and who's local to me, and I started going to her place. And let me tell you, they were light as a feather. First of all, I asked her about the sensitive eye adhesive and she said, I don't use it because they don't hold long enough. So that's the one thing. I don't fault the other place, because I asked for that and they were just accommodating me, but this woman who's been doing it like a really, really long time, she said, that stuff doesn't work. It doesn't keep the lashes on. And as long as you're applying them properly, you shouldn't have any issues with the adhesive bothering your eyes. I said, okay, great. So she said, let me send you a list of the ingredients that are in the adhesive that I use. So I checked them all out on Environmental Working Group, EWG.org, and only one of them was like higher up for like, I think allergens, but nothing was like hitting high on the scale for being carcinogenic or an immunotoxin or neurotoxin. So I felt pretty good about the adhesive she was using. And she said, you know, it lasts and that's why she uses it. So I went ahead and I hear little footsteps above me. We're coming down the stairs. So I went to her and we did classic lashes. So I had done the volume, and I had gone back and forth between classic and volume, and she just did classic. And she, let me tell you, when the lashes that she applied to my lashes were so like light as a feather. Like I didn't have any soreness, no itchiness, nothing. And she was using like the more, long lasting adhesive. And they're just so light. Like they did not bother me at all. Nothing. And I was like, holy crap. Like this is amazing. They feel so good. Like I could like squish my eyes. Like I couldn't like squeeze my eyes really tight with, the other ones, and with these, they were just so light and felt so good, and they looked really pretty on. So I went to her three times, and got classics. And actually this last time, I just went yesterday, I said, I really think I'm ready to try the volume lashes. So she was like, sure, no problem. So she did the volumes, and let me tell you, it's finally exactly what I've been looking for. Like I finally got the look that I've been wanting all along. You can see my lash, I have makeup on, but you can see how fluffy they are and how light they are. And like, if I touch them, they just feel like my lashes. Oh my gosh, it's like the best thing ever. I am just so, so happy and thrilled with these lashes. I don't have to put any liner on. I just put on shadow today, did my brows, and have my lashes. So I just wanted to say, take your time, do your homework and investigate different places, different technicians, and try a couple different people, because I really feel like it's not something that you're just like, oh, I'm gonna run out and get eyelash extensions. And the reason I got them is because I don't wanna have to put the band on all the time. The adhesive, the latex adhesive, the duo adhesive I was using and applying to my lid was like creating like a little scab. And I knew that that was because there's probably some things in that adhesive that really weren't so great for my eyelid, and that's a sensitive area. And especially with aging, pulling that band off and then like tugging at my eye is not gonna help with decreasing wrinkles, right? So I'm really, really super happy with these lashes. They don't hurt, they don't itch, they don't come off when I cry. I had lost a significant amount of the classic lashes from the last time I had gone because of the fact that I actually had the flu and I was a little sick. And what my technician was explaining is a lot of times when you're ill and then you get better, your body kind of sheds all of those like old cells and you might lose a little bit more like hair. So that could have been what's happened. She's noticed that other people, when they've been ill and gone through something, when they come back, they may not have retained as many lashes. So, but for the most part, they last. I go every 3 weeks and she is wonderful. And I'm really super happy with the results. I'm going to get information from her about like what kind of lashes she's using. And I'll link that in all the information down below. So you guys can, if you're interested, you can look for somebody in your area that specifically uses this type of adhesive and these type of lashes. And I would just say, look for somebody who's experienced. And if they're not that experienced, just make sure that they have like a mentor or somebody who is experienced that can help guide them so that you can get the best experience with your lashes. All right, bye.